ยังไงเลยรักฉันในวังน้ำดึงกันนะรีบวันนี้ทำให้กูรักฉันในปัตตานีตั้งฉันเกลี้ยงานเธอเป็นยาวังสติลเอาไว้Waste a m o r t a n t is s o t a n t t h a can't go in a b u s y n o m e t h I s o u l a t e n I e v e t e n m o o g r a n d a s u e t o Talos ka pa at natasalon na yung
bersyukur tak terkira. tukar senyuman dan salam. Tiada mentiarahi tutur dan kata yang sopan, saling memaafi suasana. Di mana pun jua memberikan ketenangan dan mencengkeramkan jiwa.
Assalamualaikum and salam sejahtera everyone. I hope everyone can hear my voice, okay? My name is A.R. Ida Razak and I will be moderator for you today. Yeah? For your information, this is the phase 3 of the 15th series of the webinar session brought to you by Professional Service Productivity Nexus, PSPN, Malaysia Productivity Corporation, MPC. Yeah? So we are approaching already Hari Raya on Sunday. So I hope you enjoy this last series from us. Before that, do you know what is PSPN? Under the Malaysian Productivity Blueprint, MPB, launched in 2017, professional service subsector has been identified as one of the 9 productivity subsectors under the 11 Malaysia Plan leading to the establishment of the Nexus. PSPN covers 6 profession disciplines, namely accountancy, advertising, architecture, engineering, and also legal and management consultancy. Yeah? And then we have the Nexus, comprises the industry leaders, government official, professional players, academia, industry association. They work closely hand in hand, promote public-private networking and support professionals to understand and tackle their productivity challenge on the ground. They act as the change agent to drive productivity trajectory of this subsector. So all these 6 fraternities has its own focus group leaders within their respective fraternities. And PSPN is championed by none other than technologist Chu Kok Beng, the CEO of Malaysian Service Provider Confederation, MSPC. Yeah? So Chu leads the industry professionals focused on enhancing productivity of professional service through common interests and digitalization goals. So all right, now we move on to the today's seminar. So a lot of information that we hear about coronavirus illustrates something terrible. People are very scared because they often see numbers of victims broadcast from disaster perspective. Not many people talk about this pandemic as something that will benefit our lives in the future. This life is forced to be appreciated, human values and the balance of nature. Business is built on the power of enormous capital. This wood is very capitalistic and only oriented towards the growth of mathematical economy. In fact, if we see the quality of the environment of our city will feel better, non-renewable energy is consumed less, and the greater the power in our family values increases. So property as a real estate product will be one of the success factors in building a future civilization. Houses are no longer fenced and individualistic. They are turned into good and friendly neighbors. The office is no longer wasteful for consuming fossil energy and inefficient space. They build new habits in their meeting online. Supermarket feel laxer than people who come, but merchandise remains in the demand and can be ordered online. Eh? So today we have none other than our professor, A.R. Saifuddin Muttaqi from Yogyakarta, Indonesia. I welcome him, who will be delivering Reimagine Real Estate in the New Normal. Eh? Professor Muttaqi, can you open your camera? Yes. Hey. And also, hi, Bapak. Wassalamualaikum. How are you?
Fine. Yeah. I'm fine, thank you.
How's Yogyakarta?
Yogyakarta is good.
Yeah, very good. Really,
but yeah. A little bit hot.
Eh? So, Bapak, okay. Without further ado, I will introduce Bapak first to all the participants. There's about 50 participants now. So I'll talk about Bapak's background first, yeah? Okay? Okay. So Bapak AR Professor Ahmad Saifuddin Muttaqi from IAI has worked as a professional architect since graduating from Architecture Engineering from Universitas Gajah Mada, UGM, yeah, Pak? And yes, he joined the Universitas Islam Indonesia to pioneer the founding of School of Architecture in 1987. He worked as a lecturer and did architect and practice to prepare for the UII Integrated Campus Master Plan. He designed a number of lecture buildings and began serving public needs for building architecture, planning and design services. He is one of interfaith and cultural dialogue activities. He worked for humanitarian service, especially with his competence in designing building used to help people affected by earthquake in Bantul, provide earthquake friendly buildings. He designed social building as such as small mosque to worship, Islamic boarding school, humanity first hospital. He is member of Acacia Committee on Architectural Education under the leadership of Ganendra Shekhawat, and constantly contribute to Asia and ASEAN research development. Okay, Pak. Sudah ready, okay. Pak. So without further ado, I pass it to you for your presentasi, Pak. Okay. Silakan.
Thank you. Thank you, Rida. I would like to share my presentation today. Today I will share my experience and knowledge about real estate development amid the coronavirus pandemic. And then I would like to choose the topic. The topic title is Reimagine Real Estate in the New Normal. Okay, now we have three keywords. Reimagine Real Estate and New Normal. So I would like to share this presentation, this knowledge, in three part. First, I would like to explain how about the real estate, and then we enter into the pandemic COVID-19. When on the other hand, in pandemic COVID-19, we have two conditions. First condition, when the outbreak comes, and then we adapt. And now, would like in the Venice, we re-entry to goes to new normal. Okay, so what is the real estate? The real estate is an approach to the development of the built environment that is a plan by considering aspect of the product, market, legal and financial comprehensively. The real estate element is the property, land, building, airside above the land, and underground right below the land. So the kind of product of real estate, like residential, commercial, industrial, and like a vacant land. How is the development of real estate? Of course, especially in Indonesia, real estate development begin with the acquisition of land by considering the location values factor. Then an established plan is developed and developed by finalizing land. And after the major land is continued by construction, road infrastructure, drainage, regional utilities. As is this stage, it can be called estate legal permissible. So our step here. Furthermore, property product can be built on the area that are ready to develop, such as residential, commercial, and industrial. So this is real estate development, and then ready to enter the property market. How do you consider choosing location? Yeah, the main capital for real estate development is the availability of land, and important consideration in choosing the location for the land acquisition are first type of land, unproductive, we're choosing it, and strategic land value. Second, land characteristic, like not sharp contour, not degraded land, but already formed. And third, easy of location, like size, like site, the accessibility of public facility and social facility. And fourth, availability of public transportation network, like MRT, LRT, BRT, etc. And final, reasonable cost both of in land acquisition and site development. And now, how about the real estate planning team? The real estate development team consists of three elements: developer, architect and engineer, and real estate consultant. Each element has a different task according to their competence, but there is a similar pattern. That is, they all start from research. Like you see, this is research for architect and engineer. This is research for a real estate consultant. And planning, all their design, engineering, and so on. Technically, financially, legal licensing, and then a marketing document. So this is so many part of to finish the how the product can goes to the market. That is real estate. So this is the COVID-19 pandemic. Yeah, the COVID-19 pandemic has had a sudden and significant impact on all aspects of people's lives, with 2.6 billion across the world. The COVID-19 pandemic is now a truly global phenomenon, with 2.6 billion people, a third of the world population, now living under some sort of lockdown quarantine. The short-term human of economic impact is undeniable as people stay at home, office and shop close, and production stall. So how does the pandemic respond proposed? Like that I said, we have four stages, but I would like spread to a part. First stage, prepare. When it was first discovered that pandemic occurred, the community lock shop manifests by various reaction, and that was reality. Over time, the community began to adapt, and business was attempt, even though it is was managed from home. Yeah. So new habits are formed. Wait a minute. New habits are formed also in a short time. It can be as a capital enter to real business. Under then, business found the new path at the new normal era. So this is prepared, respond, re-entry, and reimagine. So the short the business will not go back to the way we knew before the pandemic, but will reinvent themselves to be more resilient, adapting their operational model to the new normal. So the short-term impact for occupier is proving to be significant, as their business as usual activity are affected with the change occurring on the daily basis. The immediate shock and realization of the outbreak is now over, and the majority of occupiers are in response mode after short and immediately action. Occupier facilities and sending their workplace back to work and several waves. Yeah, this is a spatial research on the risk of the spread of COVID-19. For example, sub-district in Jakarta, capital city, that are potentially vulnerable to the spread of COVID-19 based on general parameter related to COVID-19. Yeah, I took the data in 31 March to 29 April, and the analysis was released May 5. Number of elderly population over 60 years old, people who are chronically illness over 45 years old, and distribution of vital point such as traditional market and mini market, which has a potential as the point of the super spreader, as an virus spreader to many people. So this is the result. This study provide information spatially in the map format, so the distribution of COVID-19 can be determined based on the criteria of the elderly and chronic disease. For the local government, its mapping is very, very useful for making appropriate decision according to the affected situation. And then mapping of the distribution of the traditional market that are vulnerable to crowding and information on population density, people per kilometer square, will be useful to know the distribution pattern. Likewise, the distribution of mini market in urban village or kampung will strengthen information about the pattern of the spread of COVID-19 in particular area. What suggesting for prevention? First, the traditional market need to regulate the movement of goods and people in the market, and it's surrounding by sub-district responsive task force and alert resident. Second one, coordination with the merchant association to make a delivery services to the public through an online system. And third, the mini market can apply social distancing rule by display setting mini marker with space every 1 meter in the cashier line, hand sanitizer at the provided at the cashier, and supervision mini market, independently by local government standby. And fourth, strong and fast mutually cooperation between the government and the community, as well intensive coordination between village or kampung. And now we would like to share about the research. The other research for the tall building, that I say why a building is not a tree. Yeah,
Bapak, like Bapak. Hello, Pak.
Yes.
Ada satu soalan ya dari peserta ini. Saya selit sebelum Bapak masuk ke building is not a tree ya.
Yes.
Some of the participant are quite amazed by the mapping just now. Yeah, you showed demographic of high risk, vulnerable, traditional market and mini market. That one was from the government or from these two graph. That one is from the government or from the architects research?
From university. Yes, from university. This is a research of PhD program in National University of Singapore.
I see. Okay. So they share the information with Indonesia. Next. About the this one, eh? Okay. All right, proceed.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
Continued. Okay. Continue. This is of other research come from UK. It take Christopher Alexander landmark in 1965 paper can still guide us in thinking about the coronavirus and other urban challenges. What are the lessons of urban destiny in private place. One of topic that need careful assessment in the wake of the pandemic is the impact of tall building, which also tend to bring many people into close contact, notably in their elevator lobby or other space. Like epidemiologist Sailin has observed that the incidence of the infectious spread can be high in the tall building. He has drawn an analogy the spread of coronavirus and other disease in cruise ship. So in a boat environment, people tend to crowded into elevator, stair, and other common area. In boat environment, infection of all kind can be spread rapidly. Like see you like this, the sprawling tree like pattern at the top of this drawing make it much more difficult to travel the different destination by transit or especially by foot. You see in the up drawing is like a gated community, and the pattern of the lower part of the drawing is much more interconnected, so offering many more ways to move and connect. Yeah, this is block, like a block housing. And you see the design and density, the UK Urban Task Force demonstrated in the figure that the same population density can take very different from with the very different connective properties. Like you see the red line and different impact or health and vitality, including disease transmission. So the drawing that at the start of this post makes this point, we can contrast tall building with the street line. With the tightly packed row houses or a series of small apartment building, each with its own entry on the street, such as the web network allow people to be social proximity, able to practice what I have called sociable distancing without being force into kind of agency that allow transmission pathogen. You see, you can see the red line that show the movement of the people in and out of the building. In the tall building, there is a concentration in the movement of people in the corridor and elevator. Whereas in the low-rise housing, moving from one to another at the ground level, whereas the building with the high mix function, they move is simpler because it does not have to be far to get public facility. So you see, this is the tall building and land housing and a mix housing with the middle rise building. Okay, why the building is not not tree? So I mean this, what is the deeper problem with the decentralized space? One can think of the structure of the tree where all the branch, twig and leaves are connected into through the trunk. So similarly in the tall building or a cruise ship, all the parts are connected through central elevator, stairway, and common space. By contrast, a web network doesn't have to concentrate everyone into central space, even when a given unit of space has a same number of people, that is the same destiny. Okay. So standard protocol COVID, like you see, we have healthy living protocol, wash your hand with hand sanitizer, wear the mask if coughing and sneezing must to be close. And now we have a social distancing, meaning the maintain physically distant, but getting close socially and enhancing personally spiritually. So stay at home, work from home, learn from home, and worship from home. Now we show you the response of the social distance at social distancing at home. In how about this suggestion for staying at home to build creativity to use the house as a workshop, study room, environment room, and sport, and even as a place for of worship. The space in house become very flexible to accommodate various function. So new habit are born at home. Now, respond in social distancing at home, like for musician, their home is a part of music studio that is with the other artists to entertain. They do about music concert from home. And for community, the house need to adjust to be able to together dance before in their television alone. So if you are all of you hear the song in the opening this moment, this is Didi Kempot, yeah, come from Indonesia. He said that he is a lord of broken heart. This is artist Didi Kempot as managed encourage people to donate reach 7.6 billion rupiah, 7.6 miliar rupiah. But now he is die and he is a few days later because he was so very tired. Rida, maybe you can play the song.
Oh, this one.
This is Didi Kempot. Yeah. The Pamer Bucu.
Okay, Pak.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Proceed.
Okay. Next. Okay. Yeah. Next. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. And then we would like to respond what the social distancing at home in the like a sport or a outdoor yard, yeah, inside of home and of his house in the garden outside, the house become important to be able accommodate even the slightly sport activity. The family room in the from of the TV, the terrace and the kitchen can be used for sport, and the yard cultivated to get the direct sunlight for sunbasting. Yeah, and this is a response to social distancing at the public facility. The traditional market in Central Java choose how to arrange the plot of every trader who is the in the market, both brought out. Market manager could consider that the potential of transmission will be very high if the it remain to market due to limited space and poor air circulation. So by being outside, trader are not worried about large numbers of visitor, even though they still have to comply with distancing social protocol. Jadi the layout of plot traditional market trader has changed to meet the physical distribution and empty outer space like a road to use the whole merchandise. Okay, and respond to social distancing in public facility in the mini market, traditional market, the layout of plot like mini market socializing about physical distancing and giving a signal to queue as a new habit in maintaining physical distance. Display space in set to maximum capacity with ratio of 10 meters square per person. So they are sleeping with this protocol. Now, in commercial building, such as mall, supermarket, bank, management applies strict standard for preventing COVID-19 transmission. The police are involved to maintain the order of the queue, search of the group and enter the room. So you see, this is Grand Indonesia with social distancing protocol. And now I would like to share about respond to social distancing and industrial estate. The governor of Central Java is actively conducting socialization of the distancing social protocol to factory. Plant managers are invited to participate, is assessing the risk of transmission. If they do not consider social distancing, will be very high transmission. You see, this is a link of YouTube. So I would like to share for a minute about this link. Rida, is it okay to see the
Sekarang semuanya latihan
jaga jarak, yes, ngantri dengan baik.
Iya, Pak.
Orang yang menangkan.
Maju,
coba buat 2 shift. 2 shift, ya, Pak. Coba buat 2 shift. Apa masih di sini? Jaraknya.
Lama depannya, Pak.
Menangkan kepan paling tidak 1 meter. Baik, coba.
Temennya jangan dipegang, ayo sampean maju, sampean. Eh, sampean maju.
Oke, bagus.
Sampai dulu, sampai bekerja, saya ingin mengambil waktu sebentar saja. Corona ini tidak mudah, corona ini sulit, dan ternyata sudah banyak korban. Mari antara kita semuanya menjadi tentara yang baik, tentara kaya apa yang bisa melawan COVID ini adalah kita sendiri. Caranya tidak sulit, caranya jangan tidak usah bersentuhan dengan temannya. Oke? Okay?
dari saat masuk sampai di dalam ruangan kerja, kita selalu menjaga itu minimal jarak 1 meter. Sehingga untuk penularan terhadap penyakit COVID ini bisa diminimalisir dengan adanya physical distancing. Total jarum sekitar 50.000. Ya. Kalau di sini kira-kira ya 4.500, tapi kita bagi di 2 set ya. Sehingga jaraknya itu bisa terjamin.
Yes.
Wah, hebat Pak. Ya, videonya hebat ya.
Ya.
Yeah,
the governor arranged the way to line up the factory workers in his smile style, yeah. He showed it for worker to keep this distance physically as a form of enforcing social distancing protocol. Yeah, this is a best practice can inspire to other regional leaders, such as Governor of DKI Jakarta, yeah, West Java or East Java, and other part of Indonesia. Okay, so next we would like to share the final step about planning for re-entry and new normal. Okay. The occupant, there is a current of limited visibility on the timing of the next stage, but companies are now planning for re-entry. This space is complex to navigate, the requiring some restructuring on courages from business leader and their workspace. So, occupier must determine the level of modification required to return to business. Prepare, redesign, and fit out workplace ready enough to invite employee back to the office. Combine with the remote working capabilities and a robust triage approach. It is not about getting back to the office as soon as possible, but opposite approach. That is first and foremost about technology. What does it take to re-entry facilities that we are closed a week ago, bring people back to work and return to stable business activity? So what function must come back when the re-entry option is available? Okay. This is the urban housing estate, the flexible space, and urban farming. I think it's the opportunity, a housing estate in urban area might be considered a self-contained design element, such as sunroom or space for urban agriculture to accommodate the lack of outside space. The experience of working from home may still continue to the home needs to provide flexible space. Yeah, working from home, yeah, so need to provide flexible space. The house become more open to that neighborhood pattern will be more familiar. Currently, we are learning how important the organization of our space is in promoting productivity. Yeah, I think like this, urban agriculture can be a productive activity for family in the post-pandemic era. The prepared space from farming will double, which is to produce agriculture product and can be used as a healthy socializing space for housing resident. Yeah, spatial application can be carried out in longitudinal corridor or and the concrete floor of the roof, how to farm can be done together between resident of the housing and the result they can enjoy themselves. Yeah. So I think the co-living concept as an alternative solution. Co-living is a modern form of the shared housing for like people to live, work, and play together. Fully furnished, especially designed living space, create an inspiring environment for people to interact and share experience. The biggest value of joining a co-living space is access to the community, the highest price and real estate, and increasing solitary lifestyle are leading people to seek new ways of living. Despite the similarities with the Stadenhuis, so co-living combined many other aspects such as sense of community, sustainability, and collaborative economy. So how can our co-living communities are designed to handle COVID-19? We are continuing to battle the COVID-19 pandemic and adapt to the enforcement of the social distancing and stay home mandate. So co-living tenants have felt compelled to navigate the loopholes in the design of their communities to discover new ways of living with the others. So while also mitigating health risk, so co-living communities may be better positioned to handle a pandemic while balancing a sense of normalcy more so than traditional residential real estate offering. At that time, the new normal, staying at home, will become a prestigious lifestyle. Yeah, like this prestigious home lifestyle. They stay home more, prioritizing basic need, like you know Maslow triangle, to be fulfilled. Then they will be very, very friendly with co-virtual. So, and the social personal will feel more socially empathy. Yes. So what shelter mean in the new normal? People will value their homes more than before and aims to make a space more functional and fluid in the proposals, and underutilized spaces are now being used to varying ways, from mudroom, etc., being transitioned into temporary office to living room, become spaces for physical activity, and we see people appreciating simpler lifestyle, whether at home or in life. So now more than ever in a world that's so very complex, we spend more time in our home. We will grow to appreciate ways in which we can conserve energy through thoughtful design and added technology. Okay. The house was developed with the concept of living, co-living, with the hallmark of the shared space. The atmosphere of togetherness between residents can be felt while maintaining physical distance. Yeah. In their personal area, they provide personal contemplation space, spiritually and personally. This is living in the new normal era. Okay, so we next in the work space or work style adaptation post COVID-19. Change changing protocol and workspace design. First, reduce workplace density, reduce distancing standards, remote. So smart office and co-living co-working space. Sorry. Yeah, smart office Bapak, and co-working
space. Bapak boleh bisa go back to the slide before because the line was not so clear.
Is it?
Yeah, can you explain this slide back because the line was not so clear. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. This is work style adaptation in post COVID-19. We changing the protocol and workspace design. How about this? So first we reduce workplace density. Okay. Okay. Because density is so very sensitive to contact in, yeah. Redesign space to maintain new distancing standard. Okay. And second, new protocol to reduce gathering while enabling collaboration. And third, provide new facilities as a substitute to reduce travel need because we are going work at home at place, so it goes to other space. So provide new facilities as substitute to reduce travel need. So and fourth, enable remote working to continue working from home like this. Maybe in a week we have 5 days. So and next in the new normal, we can combine working from home 2 days plus 3 in office. Or 1 day in home and 4 in office. So 4+1 or 3+2, like this. Okay. Next. This is smart office and co-working space. The coronavirus pandemic also emphasized the need for healthy building and augmented workplace wellness. Air quality and ventilation, for example, will become a greater priority. Ample fresh air help to dilute airborne germs, and research indicate that higher humidity could help prevent viruses from spreading rapidly. So smart building could also be designed to collect information on the behavior of people working inside to help inform decision making in a crisis. Smart building will likely to be outfitted with the infrared monitor that can automatically screen occupant body temperature as they enter the building or in sit in their desk. So those with a fever may be asked to go home and for rest and recuperation. Yeah, this is protocol next. So the coronavirus pandemic also emphasized like for healthy building like this, focus on what focus on wellness on a post coronavirus work will also extend to mental health. You see, both liner, the mental health. While we don't yet understand that the full emotional impact unanticipated remote work, we do know that isolation can have a serious impact on mental health. Companies will now needed to pay greater attention to mental health of their employees. So doing so will require heightened human observation to watch of signal of distress. to that end, manager will need to be thoughtful and intentionally in their relationship with others. They must become familiar with what stress look like and be prepared to act. The successful commercial real estate firm will be depend on how effectively and quickly they make decision and take action. They will need to embrace the precept of discover, decide, or do to effectively move the next phase of office design. So early virus containment effort in Singapore or Taiwan was successfully because they officially took rapid action. How efficiently a commercial real estate companies can do the same will determine their future success. So you see, for example, the brand we work, the set of office space company is making plan to change the set workplace in the post-coronavirus world, proposing a new floor layout, adding sanitizing capabilities and shifting office traffic flow. Yeah. You see, this is a nuance of social distancing protocol must be disciplined for that. Hospitality estate, like a hotel and shopping mall. You see, the infrared thermometer is available at the front desk for employees and guests to check body temperature. The social distancing protocol will enforce by marking to help separate the guests, and required masks to be worn in public area. Guests must avoid contact with hotel employees when checking in, and when checking out, the room will be sprayed disinfectant and left empty 24 hours. So expect to see more technologically being implemented in check-in and check-out process. For instance, like Hilton already has an application that let you see your smartphone to check-in, select your room, and use as a room key, not requiring by any human interaction. Yeah. Breakfast buffet can be one of the most convenient service for business travel, but due to the close contact with the employee and other guests, and service has been removed or any location, many location. Additionally, but not all hotel maybe have closed or limited their food and beverage. Similarly to food and beverage services like gyms, spa, and other services are likely to be shut temporarily or be limited in service available. So you see like this. Yeah. Social distancing in hotel. Some hotel were turned into dormitory for medical staff and even become quarantine hospital with the COVID-19 patient. So in Indonesia, like Wisma Atlet and other country, there are hotel chains to quarantine hospital. Hotel management implement strict protocol to maintain physical distance. Social distance in hotel and hostel. Yeah, see hostel so many bed, but some hotel and hostel were turned into dormitory for medical staff and even Department become quarantine hospital with COVID-19 patient. Hotel manage, yeah, like implement strict protocol to maintain physical distance. As social distancing in shopping mall, yeah, stricter safe distancing measure will be introduced to reduce the risk of further location transmission. The authorities announced, like on March 20, even with the viewer to 150 people and operator with venue accessible to the public must implement measure to ensure separation of the least with us.
Pak Saifuddin, are you still here with us? Or you disconnected? Hello? We lost Bapak Saifuddin. Try to get his audio back.
From one paper to another. Yeah.
Bapak Saifuddin, we lost your audio the slide before. Can you go back to the slide before? Yeah. Can you go to the slide before?
Yeah. Is it?
Yeah, correct.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, in social distancing in shopping mall, sticker safe distancing measures will be introduced to reduce the risk of further local transmission. So the authorities announced about this, now, until now, even with fewer than 250 people and operator of venue accessible to public must implement measures to ensure the separation of the least 1 meter between patron. Okay, yeah, this is make a physical distancing, make sure that physical distancing can be done. Yeah, so but you see in this layout it there are discipline and the others are not disciplined. This is what the handicap of our challenges in future, yeah, in the new normal. So this is important for the result, yeah, like we expect investor will continue to look to few consideration as major arbiters to asset level risk in the near term. Yeah, income stability, the less variable to contractual income, the less risk. Okay, this favor the living sector and office asset with the credit tenancies, lower exposure to variable rent, and strong remind terms. And second, operation critically. Yeah, the more important the facility and tenancy to revenue and business operation, the lower risk this waiver data center and critical logistic asset, you know. And the occupation density, this is the higher the density of occupant, the higher of operational risk and contagion, risk of contagion. This greatest short-term risk for hotel, retail, select living asset, and flexible office operator. I think we might see the board line. How about the commercial estate? Yeah, in the new normal, must have protocol inside for social distance or physical distancing. Now, the result of our presentation about new normal, have a message about the sustainability message. Okay. One, reinforcing the sustainability message. Snapshot city lifestyle may be like a lower carbon, less resource intensive, and environmentally friendly. So this is good for our city. Working from home, this has massive implication for the way we design and use our home, our office, and our transportation system. Yeah, we change. So maybe it just 2 or 3 months make a new habit for us. And house design and sustainability, our home have become more than just a place where we live. Our home office, our home education center for ourselves or our children, of course, our entertainment venue like entertain from concert for the artists, our delivery procurement center. Yeah, this is a business. And fourth, wasting minimization and local sourcing. We have stronger to design out waste to maximize material use and to pressure supply chains on packaging and material sourcing. And fifth, localization of amenities and park, a rise in demand for local amenities closer to where we live as a people are restricted to their neighborhood. So I think that is a co-living concept is compatible for our living in the new era, in the new normal era. And then the last one, changing transport pattern, changing in modes of mass transportation increase like cycling or walking. So this is all of my presentation. And closing, thank you, but I have words, nothing will change the fate of the nation without them change themselves. Okay, and this Raya, stay safe and stay home. And okay, I would like to give you like a pantun. Can I in bahasa Indonesia, menunggu lama terasa bosan, agar tak bosan sambil bernyanyi. Di rumah saja tidak hanya rebahan, apa salahnya introspeksi. Okay, thank you
Professor Saifuddin for sharing your lovely talk today. When we discussed the other day, we discussed about how to bring things together, kan? Buka kamera ya, Pak. Bisa the previous slide, Pak. Previous slide, yes. Yang the slide before, the one before. Yang sebelum ini, this. Maju ke belakang.
Is it?
So this slide is very powerful, Bapak tulis nothing will change the fate of nation without them changing themselves.
Yes.
So with the new normal, kan, a lot of people with the normal thinking, they cannot move forward. But the people with open-minded and they are willing to change, that's the people that is actually thriving during this pandemic. New normal means thinking and finding new ways of doing things. So hangat juga bapak habit. Because ada some comments yang dia tidak berapa setuju sama bapak punya idea pasal pastinya but we will get to that. We will go to a few questions first, the macro questions, and then we go to the detail questions. But first and foremost, thank you very much bapak kerana sudi to put together all the type of development that is possible to take into consideration during this pandemic, especially relating to social distancing. I have not went to any webinar that is trying to actually look at the big picture, especially sharing the industrial outlook for social distancing. We tend to focus at the clusters, which is, you know, the construction and all. So I go to the first question, which is from AR Mustafa Kamal. He asked, Bapa, how is it different from the lockdown?
I know him.
Your good friend, Mustafa Kamal. He has two questions. He asked about how is the different from the lockdown of Italy and China? So that's the question. Yeah, basic lah, basic. And then the second question, I go after Bapa talk about little bit about this lah.
Okay, I know how impact in Italy is so very, very massive for the illness, because maybe there are old people there and different with what about in China. In China, it's so very, very disciplined, because maybe the government have a strictly have a protocol for social distancing. So they move people goes to their home, so they stay at home. But maybe in Italy it's not like that. So the principle may be the same, but the disciplinary is different. So the impact is different too. I think like this.
Yeah, benar, Pak. So basically, you can see also from the discipline and also the technology, all that plays a role part in terms of helping the society in terms of combating the pandemic. Yeah. So the second question from Mr. Mubakama is he was quite amazed with the governor with the video just now. Governor coming himself come down, and I saw some of Pak Ridwan coming also actually came down to actually execute what idea was 2 years ago. ATM beras become reality throughout the whole of East Java, which in Malaysia our we have the same system, but it is keep in the store. So it's quite funny, right? We also have the same thing, but we don't use, but it is widely used. But Mr. Mustafa Kamal asked about, can you explain further the concept of Jokowi PSBB, penjarakan sosial berskala besar? Yeah.
Okay. PSBB, like I think it's not to be what the relaxation is, no, because the protocol of social distancing must be strictly powerful to make it do it. People must have to habit with in his life. So PSBB now we have in 4 province and 26 regional. So I think this is mean Pak Jokowi said we must usually quote unquote living with COVID, because they didn't know when COVID has the end. So please, your habit with social distancing makes sure that you can live with COVID 19 like this.
Yes, thank you, Baba, for explaining the situation. Now we go to another question. Miss Hidi Lau from Johor Bahru. She's very interested in your diagram showing the human movement in different typologies of building. what is the new possible building model that we can explore in the new normal, particularly in the high-rise typology? Because when you showed just now, the diagram is very concentrated, you know, and then when you go to the medium rise and the, the low rise, so all the different patterns. So how do we tackle this, especially high-rise? Because a lot of my friends are living in the high-rise. They are actually thinking of moving out to the low rise now because of this lockdown, very long lockdown. But what will be the future of this market in during this post during this pandemic?
Yeah. Okay. I think we must think what about the core, you know? Maybe there are some smart building or something smart to make it the people that come to the core, the core of the building for the tall building. So this is solution for density, because we must make sure that one person, two others have a distance physically. So in elevator, must see the wall, and they can back with his face to see the wall like this. And maybe come from in the corridor, have a more wider from the others. Yeah, from usually that we can. So I think in core system, we must change, and the aims is make the density must reduce. You know, density is very dangerous to impact for transition like this.
Correct,
but
Baba.
If in low housing, in the what makes housing with a medium higher medium level, we can go to a coffee, we can go to drugstore. It's a very short ways, so simple ways goes there. So I think it's good for our habitual to get the public facility like this. Okay.
All right. Thank you, Baba. Before this, I thought I spoke to a few developers. They were saying that they're scared of the high rise and then the stigma after this during this pandemic, whether people will actually still buy properties. So there were these two thoughts. One is actually, you know, the stigma. The other one is like the people who have the cash to actually buy this property for future investment. Eh?
Yeah.
But there's a lot of people actually don't really, because your research is on the partly is about the co-living, and that research is not taken from just anywhere, but it's also from the research from other architects, from Ash Daily, right?
Yeah.
So I think quite interesting that you bring the idea of co-living, because a lot of the emergence of the event space and co-working space, they actually closing down now during this pandemic. They cannot bear the cost because there's no people coming in to rent anymore, and they are scared of meeting other people, strangers. But with this concept of co-living, which a lot of people can accept, I know that Indonesia, in terms of the community, they are very tight. But in Malaysia, because we are from the British system, we tend to be a little bit reserved from other people. So our culture is a bit different. So it's very difficult for co-living to actually work here in Malaysia. Hence, there were a lot of people comments inside the questions, criticizing in term if it's a joke or not to have the co-living. But being that this is the new normal, we cannot be thinking like the old days. We have to think Bapa, what do you think this co-living, will it be the future of the development? Because high-rise is stigma, and then It might migrate to Paris, but the co-living, is it going to be the next moving thing? Eh? Especially, it's quite difficult to get it social distancing within the.
Your voice is so not good. Please, what the question?
Okay, the question is, how does co-living communities will, if you propose co-living, we look into co-living, how does co-living communities comply, yes, to social distancing if the density is increased at the community pockets? This community connection requires human interaction and gathering. So instead of people living by themselves, they will actually stay together. That will expose more. This is question by Miss Kylie from Sabah. Eh?
You can hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay. Okay. I know that's different from Malaysia and Indonesia, yeah? But yeah, the principle of co-living, we can share about how the common area and service area. Because if we privately have a common area and service area, we must make it our space is bigger than others. So private living is not changed, but service and common area maybe can share together. So, but there are some must strictly in social distancing protocol. So if there are many people with gathering and everything, so we must make it strictly the social distancing protocol. So if we just to make it some meeting for just 5 or 8 people, it's okay. So I think the co-living concept make have an opportunity to our, because we have learned about how we can do contact with others, person contact with resident and everything with social media contact with technology. So when we got together, we discipline in social distancing. I think the principle, but and every habit in other place may be different. It's okay if the principle social distancing protocol strictly do it.
Yes. Thank you, Bapak. I tend to agree with Bapak, because before Bapak's presentation, I couldn't see that the relevance of co-living. But after going through the whole process, looking at the real estate, where from the low-rise, medium-rise, high-rise possibility creation of stigma, then co-living quite matters, and it actually could be explored and researched more, because this is only a spark. Baru start ya, Bapak. Baru start research spark for this kind of situation. Yeah. And then while all the Asian countries are still looking in IR 4.0, Industrial Revolution 4.0, so Japan is quite advanced in terms of the next 5.0, which is Society 5.0, looking into the social economy. And a lot of economists tend to agree looking into that. The future will be social economy. Thus, that's where the urban farming is coming. But having said that, Bapak, now a lot of the designers, architects, urban designers, they always design planning at the urban plan level. But with this pandemic situation, they probably have to change the way they look into things, where they have to take into consideration going to ground to think about social master planning. Yeah, so meaning that it's not going to be just thinking about on the surface level, but they have to go to ground, really engage with the community to see what will be the emerging, not only for infrastructure, but also circular economy. What is your thinking about this matter?
Yeah. Yeah, because now I think if the land, if we have land enough to make it the composition, we can go to the land. But if our land is very, very little bit, then we must go to a tall building. So we can cross, maybe fourth floor cross with urban farming, and then fourth floor cross with the urban farming or social communities or social space like this. So many people can make it social neighborhood good. With the communication there in their building in resident. I think it's a point. So just four floor and break with the social space or public space or urban farming and so on.
Yes. It's very interesting that Bapak mentioned that because now it start to correlate with a dialogue for, like, you know, 50% office and then occupancy now. So what do we do with this office? So there's potential actually to bring urban farming into the office. Now you're talking about what do we do with this hotel, which is bankrupt, empty. What do you do with all this, you know, resort, which is empty, office 50%.
Maybe the tall building of our hotel must be changed some space, make it something outdoor, something park, something like this. I think the green building make good better for environment, yeah, because air gym is so very they can live with the humidity, high humidity. So the country in Ecuador is good for design with the passive design like this.
So okay, Baba, I will ask you one last question. This one is I don't know whether it's a difficult question, but I still want to know the answer.
Yeah.
So now because last time we always meet or travel every month to see each other, different countries. So we are engaged in tourism, yeah, Baba? Tourism, yeah.
Tourism.
So just now Baba mentioned a lot of typology of the type of buildings. But how is tourism gonna be play a part in this? Because tourism is quite badly hit by this pandemic. There's a lot of dialogues on talking about health tourism. I went to a few webinars looking at this. But the normal tourism, that one is quite something. How can this rethinking, reemerging of real estate can play a role in terms of helping the tourism industry to climb back to its feet?
Yeah.
I mean, Indonesia memang really depends.
Yeah, this is a big problem. You know, the tourism is so very happy and make many people go close and everything. So we must make sure that the principle of social distancing must what the socially to goes to with the new lifestyle, new habit lifestyle. Yeah, because if not like this, I think we cannot do everything. Yeah, because social distancing is important for breaking out the transmission. So many creativity, I think in Yogyakarta that have many place to go tourism destination. I think we must create something that we can feel about atmosphere, but we must know what about physical distancing.
Yes.
What is easy to talk but not easy to do.
I think what Bapak mentioned is quite true lah. When I was studying in Japan last few years ago, I remember my professor Iko Sugiyama from Tokyo University mentioned to me, yeah, the world will be one day borderless city, which is already happened during this lockdown. We are all borderless in the internet. Number two is now that the pandemic is happening, the people that trying to push global education and global citizenship education, run from it anymore, because everyone will use the same protocol, which is social distancing. So hence, so like you mentioned, when we travel for tourism later on, I was thinking you cannot stop tourism, but we have to travel and we have to comply to the world requirement for social distancing instead of the country social distancing. Amazing.
I'm agree.
So any final words from Bapa? Anything you want to say?
No, I think nothing will change the fate of nation without them change themselves. It's also a very, very important thing that make ourselves to change our habit in next new normal. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Bapak Saifuddin, for accepting our invites to give a talk in the MPC PSPN platform. Yeah. Hope future we will call you and you can come again. For the participant, you can download the slides at the website www.wayup.my/nixon/professional-service. So this will be the end webinar for the PSPN series before Hari Raya. We will recommence in somewhere around June, looking into a lot of topics relating to technology. A lot of big names that I'm calling, example like Mosho Fixio and Innovim and Berkshire. They will be talking about VR augmented reality project communication and also project management, social media analytics, CAD building scanner. And then one of the things that a lot of the young ones are excited about, cross-border online business empowerment platform using digital for professionals. So apparently there's a lot of on the internet that we can do business using cross-border online system where we can do 3D or we can exchange AutoCADs between each other country and the supply and demands arrive. So without further ado, thank you very much, Bapak Saifuddin. Can you open the slide back, the last slide? Okay. Yeah, thank you very much. All right. The last slide?
The last slide.
Yeah, the last slide. Okay, thank you very much to kepada participant. Okay, selamat Hari Raya and maaf zahir batin. Stay safe, stay home. Take care, everyone.
Thank you.
Okay, Pak. Terima kasih, Pak.
Terima kasih. Thank you. Apa sudah selesai dengan teman-teman semua? Sudah closing?
Yes. Ya, Pak. Ambil gambar satu.
Sebulan berpuasa, tiba Syawal kita rayakan dengan rasa gembira. Anak muda merantauan, semuanya pulang ke desa. Ibu dan ayah keriangan, bersyukur tak terkira. Bertukar senyuman dan salam, ziarah menziarahi, tutur dan kata yang sopan, saling memaafi. Suasana raya, walau dimanapun jua, memberikan ketenangan dan mencengkeramkan jiwa. Kuih dan muih beraneka macam, jangan hanya lihat.
lagi.
Wahi gandodol, jangan lupa zaman bersama, asyik bertembang, maci dan maci, aduh, tanah diberi.
Bukan linknya Rida, katanya Rida.
Ini gimana?
Berlalulah sudah Ramadan, sebulan berpuasa. Tiba Syawal kita rayakan dengan rasa gembira. Alam muda dirampok, semuanya bulan desa. Ibu dan ayah periangan, bersyukur tak terkira. Kue dan mui beraneka macam, makanlah jangan hanya dipandang. Rendang sila nikmati, bawang dan memasak malam kembali. Wajikan dodol, jangan lupa senang para nenek zaman bersama, asyik bersembang, baci dan maci, hai duit halal tanah diberi. Thank you.